So Shoko was ordered for Attorney Del Grab. But remember, Mr. Chairman, that we have already sent two invitations. This is the second hearing that we invited the former president. And the first invitation was answered by Attorney Del Grab. No, for on behalf of the president, in the absence of that authority being requested by this committee through this representation during the last hearing. Now, Mr. Chairman, looking at the answer, looking at the reply of Attorney Derga on the first hearing, well, in fact, Mr. Chairman, naglulukuhan tayo dito. Why? Why? Because the first reply made by Attorney Derga representing the former president is that the excuse is that the president, the former president, needs much rest, and assured this committee that he will be present in the next hearing. At the same time, he has a specific date, Mr. Chairman, given to this committee through this letter after November 1. And let me read, Mr. Chairman, allow me to read in toto the portion of such reply coming from Attorney Delga. Hence, my client respectfully requests to defer his appearance before the Honorable Committee scheduled tomorrow. Rest assured of my client's willingness to appear before the House of Representatives on some other available date, preferably after November 1, 2024. And for the record, Mr. Chairman, the invitation that was sent to the former president and was answered by Attorney Derga was before the presence of the former president in the Senate. And he has promised us, this committee, through his letter, that after November 1, he will be present in today's hearing. Ano to? Naglulukuhan tayo dito? Well, in fact, I will not discuss and argue with our colleague, Congressman Kit Flores, with regards to the content of this second letter. But, malinaw po, Mr. Chairman, na naglulukuhan tayo dito. Naglulukuhan tayo dito because this first letter promised us that he will be present after November 1. Kung hindi tayo naglulukuhan dito, eh ano? Natatakot siya? Napumunta dito? That's why, Mr. Chairman, that's why my first motion was to issue a show cause order for Attorney Delga to answer both letters. And, Mr. Chairman, and I would like to reiterate once again that we should invite again the former president to be present in the next hearing.
Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Paduano. As I promised, Congressman Fernandez,
yes.
And then we will rule on the motion.
Okay. Mr. Chairman,
Congressman
Mr. Chairman, there are three reasons mentioned by Attorney Delgra in a consultation with the former president para hindi po siya umaten ng ating pong hearing. First, binanggit po niya yung pangalan ko at binanggit niya yung pangalan ni Chairman Abante. Nag-prejudge na po kami doon sa mga binanggit niya po doon sa Senado. And citing some provision of Republic Act 9851, particularly Section 6 on the willful killing. And with this, Mr. Chairman, we are being accused that na nabahidan ng prejudgment yung mga issue that he mentioned. With that, Mr. Chairman, para lang po mawala na tong issue to, again, Mr. Chairman, I'm willing, this representation is willing to inhibit myself in asking questions with regards to this willful killing. And I hope that my co-chair here, Chairman Abante, will do the same in relation to the press issue that the former president, with consultation of his lawyer, cited in this letter. Secondly, that's the reason why we asked the presence of Colonel Grijaldo to be here, because he accused us of coercion and harassment and threats. And that's the reason why we are questioning, no, yung mga medical certificate that he submitted to this Congress. We wanted that the integrity of this Quadcom will be cleared eventually. And with that, Mr. Chairman, eradicating the coercion and harassment and the threats that he accused us, then the reason for the President not to attend on this Quadcom will be eliminated. Thirdly, Mr. Chairman, the only last reason that he mentioned in this letter is all the questions were already answered in the Senate. And that is not true because we have a lot of 20,000 questions that we wanted to ask him. And with this, Mr. Chairman, yung pong reason niya for not to be here is not acceptable. So, Mr. Chairman, I believe that my position, no, trying to inhibit ourselves, ano, in this investigation pertaining to the number one issue that he mentioned, and also with the issue of Colonel Grijaldo, we will comply with the mandate of this Quadcom to inhibit ourselves and be a part of the resource persons that will be questioned by the members of this Quadcom. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Dan Fernandez. Now, Congressman Ace Barbers. There was a motion earlier that the committee invite Attorney
Mr. Chairman, you are recognized.
Thank you. That Attorney Delgra, being the counsel of the former president, be invited in the next hearing. And we direct the committee secretariat to take note of that and send the invite in the next Quadcom hearing to Attorney Delgra. Any second? Duly seconded. Any objections?
I object, Mr. Chair.
May I know what is the objection of Congressman?
We'll get nothing from him, Mr. Chair. He always just going to say is that is what my client said. So that's the end of it,
Mr. Chair.
1 minute suspension.
Para sa may init na balita sa loob at labas ng bansa, subscribe na sa Teleradio Servicio YouTube channel.